Immunofluorescence assay is a part of labeling technique that uses microscopic and fluorescence techniques. It is to detect and visualize targeted antigen expressed on cells of specimen via antigen-antibody reaction. In this assay, fluorophore is the key substance in visualizing the antigen-antibody complex under the microscope. Because of its ability to emit light in various wavelengths, or colors, when exposed to UV light. In order to perform this assay, you will need antibodies, fluorophore or fluorescent dyes, immunofluorescence assay kit, and fluorescence microscope. Firstly, let's look into direct immunofluorescence assay. What does direct IF use to bind to target substances? Direct IF uses a single primary antibody, which is a conjugated antibody that has been chemically linked with fluorophore. The fluorescent conjugated antibody can bind to any proteins, including viral antigens, antibodies, cell section and cells. On top of that, different colors of fluorescent conjugated antibodies can be used to detect different types of substances in a single tissue. Scientists use IF to detect the location of infection, abnormal cells, antigens and antibodies in tissue cells for diagnostic purposes. By knowing the exact location of certain proteins, scientists can diagnose and give better treatment to the patient. For example, we want to identify an antigen for Zika virus in brain tissue. The orange oval in this image represents the antigen of the Zika virus. In staining step, fluorescent conjugated primary antibody will bind to the Zika virus antigen. Then, the tissue will be observed later in microscopy. Now, in indirect immunofluorescence assay, the mechanism to stain target substances is slightly different. Indirect IF has two binding steps. Primary antibodies bind to target antigens, human antibodies, and cells. While secondary antibodies are the fluorescent conjugated antibodies, which bind to primary antibodies. For example again, we want to identify Zika virus antigen. Firstly, in staining step, primary antibody will bind to Zika virus antigen. Then, fluorescent conjugated secondary antibody will bind to primary antibodies. The result will be observed in microscopy later. Lastly, the stained tissue is observed under fluorescence microscope. The image shows a tissue infection by Zika virus. In this image, green shows Zika virus infected cells, while blue shows cell nuclei. The first layer were microscopic slide. And then the second one was a cell that contained cytoplasm and nucleus. And last layer for diagram A was a conjugate anti-serum. Meanwhile for diagram B it had the same layer as diagram A. But the third layer was unconjugated anti-serum instead. And the fourth was a conjugated antiglobulin serum. Next, the table illustrates the difference between the direct and indirect immunofluorescence. Unlike other serological assays, immunofluorescence allows researchers to detect targeted antigen by visualizing the targeted substances in a tissue sample by a single procedure. It also gave a clear location of infected area by the visualization of targeted antigen.